At this point, we have a working form on our website where it's possible to submit an article that will be published directly on the website. This was made possible by using a series of methods from the content service. We created a content node, we set the values of the properties, and finally, we published the new content node, the article. In this video, we'll be looking into how you can also use the upload field on the form to add an image to the article. Let's dive right into it. Now, as mentioned, in order to create a new content node on our website, we had to use the content service. For creating and adding new media to our website, we'll be using another service, the media service. Just like the content service was our gateway to the content API, the media service is our gateway to the media API. And just like all the other services, the media service is accessible to us directly from the service controller. Again, on the services property. Now, in Umbraco, there are by default a set of different media types. Those are file, folder, and image. To create either of these media types, we can use the create media method. Just like the create method in the content service, this method takes three parameters. The first parameter is the name of the media item, so the name of the folder, image, or file that's being created. The second is the parent ID, so where in the media content tree should the new media item be placed. And finally, the third parameter is the alias of the type that should be used. So should it be a file, a folder, or an image? In this video, we'll be creating a new image media type and a new folder to place the image into. When we left off in the previous video, we had just created our first article with properties. And this is what the article looks like. It has a title, a name, a very short summary here, some content, not a lot, but there's a little here. And over here in the right side, we have some details about the author. That's me, and that's my name here, and title. Now, the one thing missing here is, of course, the image. In the back office of the same content node, it looks like this. All properties are filled out, well, except the subtitle here, which isn't part of our model, so this will need to be filled in manually. And down here, the featured image is also missing. Now, if we were to fill in the media from the back office here, we'll click the plus sign and it'll open our media library here. That is at the moment empty, so there are no images to choose between for this article yet. Now, we don't want to be adding an image through the back office. We want to add an image via our submission form on our front end. So let's take a look at that again. We have our front end here and our submission form here. So aside from all the text boxes and text areas here, we also have an upload field. This is where we want to be able to add our image. We can do so now, of course, when we submit the form, but the image will not be added to our website or even saved. Now that's about to change. Let's close down our browser and head into Visual Studio and start working on some code. We have our controller here, which we've been working on so far. So the first thing we're going to do is access the media service. For good measure, let's move up a bit here and find our content service variable. Here we are. And then let's create our new variable under here. And we'll call it media service. And the media service is available through the services property. So we'll say services.mediaService. Great. We now have access to all the methods in the media service when we use the media service variable here. All right, let's jump down here again. And we'll continue to work with adding our image here just before save and publish method. So we'll make some room for it here. So we'll start by creating a variable for our featured image property on our article document type. Just like we did with the other properties here above, we'll say var featured image property, which equals article get model property type. And this will be our featured image. Super. Next up, we'll create the folder that we are going to be placing the new image into. So let's create a variable called folder And here we'll use the create media method from the media service. So media service, create media. All right. As we've already learned, this takes three parameters. The first one is the name of the folder. For this, we will use the name of our model. So that means that the name of the article we're creating will also be used as the name of the folder for the images. It makes things a little easier to manage in the back office when you have a lot of different articles, all with their own images. So we'll do like that. The second parameter is the parent ID. We want to place this folder in the root of the media tree for now. So we'll say -1 as the ID here. And finally, we need to choose the media type. We're creating a folder here. So let's say folder.modelTypeAlias. There we are. And then we also need to save our folder. So for this, we'll use another media service method called save. And we want to save our folder. Great. That was the first step. We now have a folder to place the image into. Now, before we move on, let's just save the UDI of our new folder here to a variable. That will make it easier for us to grab when we need to use it for creating our image later on. So we'll create a new variable, folder UDI equals folder dot, and we'll get the UDI here with method like that. All right. Now we can move on to the next step, creating our image. Before we dive into this, let's take a quick break from coding and take a quick look at what we'll be doing here. Adding an image to our content node consists of three steps, each equally important. The first step is to create the media item. This is where we'll be using the image media type we briefly learned about earlier in the video. The second step is to set the value of the media item, meaning fetching the uploaded image from the input stream and then adding that to our newly created media item. The third and final step is to add the media item to our content node, to our article. All right, with that in order, let's get to it. First things first, we need to add the Umbraco file property from the image media type. On all images added to the media library, Umbraco automatically sets the height and width of the image, as well as the size in bytes, and the extension is a JPEG or a PNG. But in order for Umbraco to do this for us when we add an image programmatically, like we're doing now, we need to make sure that we use the Umbraco file property for uploading our image. We also need to define that we want to use the image media type, which we will do a little later on. First, we'll define the Umbraco file property. We'll do that just like we've done with all the other properties. So I'm just gonna grab one of these here, copy it, and paste it in down here. And let's just give it another variable name here. We will call it Umbraco file property. And we'll need to update it over here as well. Umbraco file. And this is of course not from article, but from the image media type. There we go. Moving on, it's finally time to create the actual image. We'll start with a for each loop to query through all images added through the submission form, just in case someone wants to add more than one image. We'll use file as the variable name, and we'll want to look for images in our featured image property. All right, now let's create this image. We will use image as the variable name here. And then we'll use create media method once more. Great. So this is the first step where we're creating the media item. For the name of this media item, we'll use the name of the file that's uploaded through the form. So for that, we'll say file.filename. Now for the parent ID, we'll use the variable we created for the folder UDI a little further up. So we'll say folder UDI, and here we'll need to use the GUID. All right, and finally for the media type, we want to use image. So let's say image model type alias. All right, that was our media item. It still does not have any values in it, it's simply just an empty media item. Now the next step is to set the value. So we'll use the variable image and method set value. This takes four parameters. First one, we'll be fetching a third service, the content type base services, which will define the base for our content type, in this case, our image media type. The second parameter is the Umbraco file property we created just before. We will use the alias as we need to tell it to use the upload property that is the Umbraco file property. So that will be our Umbraco file property. And we'd want to get the alias of it here. So we'll do like this. And to the third parameter, which is the name of the uploaded image. So we'll again use file name. And finally, the fourth parameter is the input stream. So that's file input stream. All right, now this method that we've just created will add the image that's uploaded through the form to our new media item. All right, next step, let's save our media item. So media service save and image. Great. The third and final step here, we need to set the value of the property on our document type. So with this, we will add the new media item with our image to our article. So we'll say article set value. And in here, we need the alias of our featured image property. So that was, featured image property, and we want the alias. And second, we need our UDA of our image. So image, UDI. And this needs to be a string. Alrighty, and that's it. Any image we upload through our form submission on our website will now add an image to our article. Now that we have all the code in place, I think it's time to take it all for a spin. So let's start up our project. There we go. And let's head over to our submit article form to submit a new article. All right, let's fill in the fields here. So test with image, a little summary here. And this time we will not skip the featured image field. No, let's select choose file and pick an image to go with this article. Let's see, I think I want to go with this one. All right, so double click the image or select open down here. And we can now see the name of our image here next to the choose button. Great. Now let's just add some more sample text to the remaining fields. Content here, name of the author, and title. All right, once that's all done, let's go ahead and submit the article. All right, that seemed to go okay. Let's check out our articles collection over here. There it is. Our new article has been added here and the image is showing along with the title and the summary. Great, let's also have a look at the article itself. So we'll click on the title here. And there we have it, our article with text and images and all. All right, let's also check how this all looks in the back office then. Remove out this and we'll just say Umbraco. Okay, let's find the articles collection here in the content tree and select our newly created article here. All right, and if we scroll down here, we'll see that all the data we submitted is added to the correct field. And we also have our featured image right here. Now, in the code, we also said that when an image was added, that it should also create a folder using the same name as was given the article. So this article is called Test with Image. This means that when we go to the media section now, we should see a new folder in the root of the media tree, which is called Test with Image. And inside that folder, we should find our image here. All right, let's head on over there and check it out. So we'll select the media section up here. All right, the folder is here. Great. And inside it, we have our image here. And if we click to inspect the image a little closer, we'll see that all the default fields for the image has also been filled in here. We have the width, the height of the image, and the size, so how large the image is. And we also have the extension type down here. Now, I'd say that we have now successfully created a complete article submission form. It lets us add both text and images, a complete article, which will be readable right away in our articles collection. As I did cover a lot of code in this video, I'd encourage you to grab a copy of the complete controller that we've been working on. You can find the link to download this on the documentation page for this video. The file contains a bunch of comments that explains the code pieces in more details. Also, the concepts and information that was covered in this video will be available on the documentation page. Now, we have a completed submission form on our website. Could we do more with it? Oh yes, there's plenty more that could be done with this form. Perhaps you would want to add even more fields, and perhaps even different types of fields, you know, instead of just plain old text fields. You might also want to look into adding some more validation and checks to ensure a nice flow when some vital fields aren't filled in properly. In the next video, we'll take things a little further and look into other properties that can be added, and we'll also add some more validation and help text to our form. So head on over there when you're ready.